Keitaro at 25 is our lowest so far.
Okay. And to be fair, considering last time we saw, Natsuno was with him in 1945, so...
Yep. Also, Keitaro gets these little bits. Those little sentences that pop up before each of his events.
No matter where I am, at least the sunset is always the same. I don't care that we lost. I'm proud my country could rebuild after what happened. But I won't accept this future.
To be fair, 1920s through 40s Japan,
that's all the more reason to go back.
Exactly a happy place, but that's a conversation for not this YouTube series.
It's my duty to fight and protect the people. I have to save as many of them as I can.
I say world history, not exactly under our purview.
What if I'm trying?
Yeah. We're here to play video games involving robots and cat drugs, damn it.
Don't get cat drugs is right.
You will make it back. No matter what it takes.
Yeah, I must succeed!
I wonder, what if I never actually traveled through time?
Yeah, cat drugs is right.
It's possible that space-time here is warped somehow. But it could just be a local effect. I should try heading toward the school. Maybe time is flowing normally over there.
Already, I didn't even get to consider anything else, huh? But there is a thing I would like to point out.
Mm-hmm.
We saw the little girl called Chihiro in his earlier chapter. And we saw her again there. If that wasn't her, it looks exactly the same. I will say that.
She said her name was Chihiro Morimura.
Yeah, she says her name is Chihiro Morimura, but I think I just have a feeling she wasn't Chihiro Morimura.
Why would she lie?
I don't think she's lying.
Who?
You're saying she thinks she's Chihiro.
Yeah, I'm saying she thinks she's Chihiro Morimura.
What the fuck?
Interesting.
Or, that's a robot.
Mm-hmm.
Or that's a clone. So, it's just... Because the way this game works, I can never count on one person being exactly who they say they are at any given time. God damn it.
You know, I think mixing the alcohol with water kind of defeated the purpose of getting alcohol.
It does water it down, literally. I mean...
Yeah.
Despite a catastrophic loss... Japan recovered quite well. It seems to have entered...
At least until 1989, when they went into an economic recession that they've never quite recovered from. Thanks to, in no small part, to real estate speculators, who the villain from DBZ, Frieza, was based upon.
A story about traveling through time to the future.
Huh.
It only ever felt like a far-off fantasy. To think it ever become a reality.
I saw that there was a new game that was coming out that, I guess, Toriyama worked on. I think it was, like called Sandland or something.
Yeah, it's based on another manga he was doing. Mm. Yeah. I know nothing about it.
That thing is beyond me. I'm no expert. But I know it's capable of some extraordinary feats. Time travel, though... Could the Sentinel possess an ability like that? Our mother's terrible at
sewing, funny.
But she made this for Chihiro. I'd never seen her struggle with anything so hard, but she did it. It's pieced together with scraps of cloth, not the best quality.
It's made with love and possibly asbestos.
Chihiro took it with her wherever she went. I checked the library for any records of such a weapon, But in all of history, nothing like it has ever existed. Not in the US, not anywhere. What was that thing?
Hurry up, Miwa-chan! Slow down, Iori-chan!
Female students.
Looks I mean, like she does, here. Miwako does kind of look like baby Chihiro. Just a bit.
But they did specifically say that those were two distinct people. That one was just helping out the other.
But there's time travel in this game.
Yes.
Isn't that...
Hi, Natsuno. How you doing, buddy?
Miura-kun? Thank goodness.
You're Natsuno Minami, right? The one I met at the shrine. What are you doing here?
I've gotta say, you had me pretty worried. I had no idea where you went.
I can't believe you're here too.
I couldn't find you anywhere. I thought you got snatched up and hauled off to Area 51. But anyway...
Thank you for being you, Natsuno.
Yes.
Wait, where have you been?
A kind student's been letting me stay at his place. Aside from that, I've been sleeping outdoors.
Didn't she... Outdoors? No, wait, never mind. He's staying with you right now.
Yep. Wait... We're before she forces him onto Juro, you are correct.
Katsuno-san.
But he was already covered.
Keitaro. She certainly is quite... Yes. I admit she's bright, cheerful, attractive. But right now, I have more urgent matters to tend to.
Okay, I see it.
Hang on. This is my mess, so I have to figure out how to clean it up. But then again... I can't really bring a boy into the house. Oh yeah! Granny Tamao went on a trip. So Juro-kun should be the only one home.
Yep, that's Juro's grandma, just making sure.
Granny Tamao.
Just checking to make sure that's still the case.
For now.
Sorry. Let me go grab my stuff really quick.
Watch, her name is actually Kalana Puka or something.
Right back, so just wait here.
The Pukas are in Odin Sphere.
No, Puka was the bitch who just died last night in Danganronpa 2. I'm dating this recording. On one hand, I like how that case resolved. On the other hand, damn, I liked Pekko. Like, yeah, that was a fun ride. That was genuinely a fun ride.
Yeah. I remember before the stream being, like, really annoyed about the whole Sparkling Justice bit, because it was, like, oh, hello. Because it was, like, I thought it was, like, a waste of time, and it, like, tied out the case. Then I voiced it! And I had a fucking blast with that.
So we are at the Kurabe house, and both of those two are here. I hit the dent and it did nothing, really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. Just keep it in mind, so.
You don't have to cry. It's not like you did
right,
this on
that's
purpose.
His sister. Fuck.
I'm sure Uncle isn't mad about it anymore.
What about you? Are you mad?
Of course not. I'm your big brother. I'll always be on your side, Chihiro. Now, come on out.
Unless you cost me a girlfriend, then we might have to talk.
Oi.
So how do you hit the pillar with the laundry bucket? You must have been playing pretty rough.
The bunny was biting, and it beat up giant ghosts. Cause the ghosts smash all the houses, and more of them keep coming.
Such strange ghosts. Did you come up with them yourself?
Why did you say
Tao told me about them.
I'm sorry, Chihiro-chan. My father has quite a short temper. I'm sorry. This was all my fault.
Tamao-san.
It only happened because I told Chihiro-chan about my dreams.
Oh, your dreams!
Sit there and say, please don't tell me that the toddler is having those dreams.
No, Tamao's dreams!
Yeah.
And as you might recall, at some point during 1945, Ryota was back here somehow giving her drugs to make her forget her dreams.
Sharing some foreign medicine with me.
Did not piece that together.
Ever since I started taking it, I keep having.
Initially, he was giving her drugs to make her remember dreams, but
more than just dreams.
Okay, her hair is the same color as Megumi's. Never mind, that's gross. She's in love with him. But also, her hair swept in the same direction as Iori's.
This is bad.
You are now convinced that everybody is everybody.
I'm just throwing shit out there. That's also, like the easiest thing to wrap my head around.
I'm going to say one fact you missed from an earlier scene while you were out getting alcohol.
Okay.
Chihiro told Tetsuya, the old Tetsuya, she prepared 19 sentinels.
No!
So
even
one
the title's a lie!
What was that, sorry? Air raid alarms have been sounded. Enemy is flying at low altitude. More air units to be expected. To prepare against the coming invasion, we ask all citizens to unite as we fortify our air defenses.
I interrupted you, sorry.
No, you didn't really. I was just letting you know that there were 19 at one point.
Oh, so you're saying six of them died. Okay.
We have to go.
Remember, we're up to Sentinel 23 on the counter with a bunch of them unaccounted for.
Juro-kun, are you home?
But at one point, there were six more active than there are now.
Couldn't you have knocked first?
And here's this scene.
Your Granny Tamao and I are best buds. We're neighbors. Think I don't know my way around the place? Anyway, I've got a favor to ask.
Oh, Minami-san. I didn't know you lived so close.
Did you really need to come out?
You're Yakushiji-san, our classmate? Wait, no way. Are you two... Do you need something from him?
We've seen the scene.
Yeah, we have.
We're now approaching it from the opposite angle, though.
Yes.
Natsuno-san?
Watching Megumi be jealous.
Pardon my interruption.
Gonna be honest, not the biggest fan of Megumi.
You know what? Fair. That...
Like, I don't outright hate her.
Who are you?
Even dislike's a little strong, but like...
My name is Keitaro Miura.
It's kind of complicated.
She doesn't really have anything going on besides obsessing over Juro. Okay, and the gun thing.
And the cat, yeah.
How do you know Minami-san?
Yeah!
Come on, I know you have a spare room.
That is fair! That is very fair. It's hard for me to pick a favorite character in this game.
Tell anyone you're living with a girl.
I can confidently say...
Details don't matter.
Me.
Just let him stay.
Don't get me wrong, she was useful in battle.
Thanks, see ya!
And her story is interesting in its way. But not Megumi.
Yeah. It's just watered down Homura.
I live super close by. So if you need anything, just let me know.
I see this as someone who didn't finish Madoka Magica.
There she goes. Well, this is awkward.
But why does he need to stay with them?
Because if you heard it earlier, been kind of staying with Shu, but more often than not, he sleeps on the streets.
Ah.
So Natsuno went, okay, I'm responsible for this mess. I gotta fix it. And the way to fix it is like, hey, the Kurabe house has a lot of extra rooms and there's only one resident there right now.
Let's continue to make Juro's life worse.
Yes.
Because she didn't know about Megumi.
Well, there's still probably plenty of room, even with Megumi there. But it was, they showed up and it's like, oh, I can blackmail Juro into doing this. I don't have to ask a favor now. And of course, if Megumi wasn't such a freaking jealous little girl here.
Girl.
Natsuno wouldn't have known she's here. Because Natsuno shows up and Megumi's like, oh, hell no, get away from my man, and marches out. At least that's how I read that little thing. Because now that Natsuno's left, Megumi's just sitting there smiling.
Do none of us like Megumi?
I kind of like her.
She's on the low end of the totem pole as far as characters I like right now.
Like, I mean, like her, but I like her significantly less than several other characters.
No offense, Star. I am just...
We get it.
Pardon me. I know Natsuno-san's intentions are
good,
but
I have been more harsh on other characters. An inconvenience.
Are you hungry?
Keitaro's just so well-mannered.
No, I shouldn't.
Yeah.
Oh, I think this is...
thinks you should.
Is this where it comes up?
Be a little later.
Okay. Okay, it's...
If we're talking about food... Are we finally going to see Himburger?
I think it's a little bit later. But I think this is the start of it.
Yep. Also, where the hell did half of the pencil go?
You're asking me?
Is she in good health?
Does Natsuno know that Tamao is a friend of Keitaro's yet?
She's visiting relatives back in Shimane.
Ah, yes. Because she met Tamao back in the past.
Cool. Yeah. And that's why she went for Juro specifically.
Yep.
Love that. We love that for her.
Do you know my grandma? Yes. You do, huh? So then?
I had the hots for her 40 years ago.
Not long. Just until I can make my way back home.
There's a lot to unpack there.
If that's the case, it shouldn't be a problem. Just try not to cause any trouble.
Cause no trouble.
Guest room on the first floor. Thank you.
So that would make Granny Tamao close to 60. Right about now.
Mm-hmm.
Assuming she didn't warp all over the place time-wise.
You never know.
Okay, I can't walk behind the dinner table there. Do not have access to the first floor guest room. Nope, can't put on the apron.
Oh, but we'd make an excellent male wife.
Possible. Okay, none of that's worth considering. Okay, there, finally the TV popped up.
There's a projection device where the radio used to be. It's been lightly remodeled, but it's the same house. I could have sworn it burned to the ground.
They probably rebuilt it.
It's only a mod.
And another question. What about that dent?
Oh, finally popped back up. Okay, I walked by it 2 or 3 times.
That dent better not be important.
The damage on this pillar is missing. And it wasn't changed when they remodeled. If this really is the Kurabe's house,
there should be a dent here.
Right here.
Oh my god, I was kidding.
Left a dent in this pillar.
Dude, the house got rebuilt.
Yep. Hello.
Oh, hello.
Oh god, we're back here.
Parents' property. There was a wooden single-story house. It was built in the middle of the 20th century.
sounds lovely. I'll have it produced for you.
Produced, huh?
You will. But all I have left are old photographs.
That's fine. I can restore them for you.
Zero escape
from Thank you, Mira-san. I'm looking forward to it. Oh. Were you just on a call with someone else?
With Professor Kurabe, yes. We were discussing the layout of the residential zone.
So,
oh, that's right.
That's...
Professor Kurabe was born in the
I want to say Iori.
She's 120 years old, right?
That's Natsuno talking to us right now.
No, the old
that's
lady.
Professor Kurabe, probably Tamao.
She's Professor
Morimura's okay.
She's Professor Morimura's mentor.
Okay.
Yeah. I was the foremost expert on AI after all.
Oh god, no.
Anyway, is something wrong?
Why does something have to be wrong for me to call? Well, I just so happen to have a really urgent problem. I need emotional support stat. And I need it from you.
Oh, that does sound urgent. Then I'll be waiting.
This ship is winning me over. What? I'm gonna pee really quick.
I'm gonna hit pause.
Okay.
So we just confirmed that Tamao Kurabe was Chihiro Morimura's mentor. Confirm that.
Mm-hmm.
And considering how far back those two go, at least from what we've seen, his little sister is very much likely Chihiro Morimura. It's just unknown exactly how the last name happened. Could be multiple ways. We still don't know. There are too many options to actually narrow anything down there.
I fucking love this game.
But those two have been hanging out for a very long time. To be a mentor, that's not a simple, you know, one-off connection. But also, the fact that the houses are different. It's the same house, but different. We've confirmed that we have time loops going on. And the fact that Keitaro in the future could just construct the new house, be it in some form of terraforming thing, or some form of simulation.
Nanomachine, son.
So we've got that advanced a few theories.
Bombshells, he says.
Bombshell!
They don't even have dental.
You never even had a first name, let alone a last name.
So what a life to live. Oh, fuck. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Christ, Johnny boy.
Oh, my God. I'm going insane.
So, yep, that's event number two. That is event number two on the timeline. The mark on the pillar is here. Hey, and back to this. The another freeloader timeline has some more stuff. I think that's everything, but yeah, okay.
History Files! Yep. To Mao Kurabe, 2188.
Leading authority on AI.
Mm-hmm. She looks much younger.
Than 120.
Nanomachines, son. Literally, in that case, nanomachines.
Mm-hmm.
Then...
we measure into Tommy mats around here.
That is actually how a lot of Japanese houses measured. Like, this is something I learned from reading things like, fucking Taiko and Musashi.
As long as it's not the metric system.
Yep, that's exactly it. Anything but the goddamn metric system.
The fuck is it called?
I was alive. The Kurabe house had a pond.
Hmm.